Hey Deckers, it's time to level up your Steam Deck, and it's never been easier to do so. So if you want your non-Steam games to go from bland and boring to absolutely epic, and you want your game screen to get completely revamped so that you've got tons more information at your disposal, as well as having really cool intro and shutdown animations, and even control how good your screen looks from the touch of a button. The good news is this is all from game mode and is simpler than ever. For those of you that have followed us for a while, we're going to dive into a bunch of new updates that haven't even been covered here before. So first off, we're going to look at all of these awesome updates that you can get for your Steam Deck, and then we'll run through how to install it all. Starting off with free games and share Decky. These are very new to the Decky markets, but if you are interested in getting free game notifications on your Steam Deck, you can see them popping up down in the bottom right there already. And if I go into the Decky menu and go to the free games, you can see all of the options here. At the moment, this is just the Epic Games Store, and hopefully this will cover some other stores very soon, like the Steam Store and even GOG. But for now, it's just Epic Games, and it does jump the gun occasionally. At the time of this video, Game Deck is not actually available as a free game. And if you look at the Epic Games Store free game section, you can actually see that Game Deck is in the next batch of free games, but Kerbal Space Program and Shadow Tactics are on the free games list. And if you look down in the notifications, they are in the notification list as well. So you can get these notifications and a quick summary of what those games are now directly from your Steam Deck menu without having to visit the Epic Game Store. Another great addition, which we didn't cover previously, is Share Decky. This looks at all of your installed games and gives you recommended settings. Now, if you want to recommend your own settings, you'll have to go to the website of sharedeck.games. But if there are configurations that people have added, it gives you a brief summary of the battery usage, frames per second, and settings, which you can then dive into to get the full details. So you can see for the Callisto protocol, there is just the one here with around 2.5 hours battery life. But if I dive into Elden Ring, you can see that there's a lot more options here for you to choose from. So you can have a nice look at what people are running and choose the best for you on the frame rate and battery life. On to some of our favorites that we have previously covered, but are here for you if you've missed those. First up is Steam Grid DB, which gives you the option to manage your artwork from game mode. Now, don't worry if you don't have the option off the bat on the first menu. If you go into a game and go to the game properties, you'll have the change artwork menu pop up in there, and then it will be available again from the top level. So from anywhere, then you'll be able to go to a game and choose change artwork from one of the pictures or even the game page itself. So if you just go into one of these and hit change artwork, then you'll get a new menu to go and look at the capsules, wide capsule and hero images to make sure that all of your game pages look absolutely fantastic. So the capsule is the one that shows up on the library screen, wide capsule is the one on the recent games, and the hero image is the one inside the game page. Now, occasionally you'll do a search and a non-Steam game, for example, will come up with the wrong images. Just open the filter menu and you can look at the other versions here. So for Moonlight, for example, it picked one of the games from Steam, whereas I wanted Moonlight Game Streaming. I can just pick that in the filters and then see all the artwork associated. Next up is one of my favorite additions, is How Long to Beat. This is the row containing the hours for main story, extras, completionist, and all styles sitting above the play button here below the banner image. And if you go to view details, this will open up the full page on How Long to Beat site, so you can get some more stats on there as well. But it's very good to just give a quick glance of how long a game can last and compare it with how far through you are. Next up is ProtonDB Badges. This is the icon that you see on the top left sitting over the top of the game banner image here. Callisto Protocol is marked as platinum, and if we go and select that badge, it will take us to the ProtonDB site and it will give you the verified status, which is playable, but the ProtonDB reviews are all saying that this is platinum, meaning it runs perfectly fine out of the box. I'll link the ProtonDB statuses in the description below so that you've got a quick reference there, but it's a great indicator to how it actually runs on the Steam Deck compared to what the Deck verified status was actually set to. Next up is Animation Changer. This is a fantastic add-on for the Steam Deck, which allows you to manage your bootloader videos, suspend videos, and transition videos in future directly from the Steam Deck. So you can see that I have the CyberDeck one set for my bootloader, which is the one that I showed at the beginning. And I also have a suspend animation of Doctor Strange here as well, which gives a portal animation. So if you want to browse what's available here, just hit the manage animations up at the top. It may take a few seconds to load, but now you have over 1,000 bootloader animations to browse through. Now I won't spend a huge amount of time here because you will probably spend quite a bit of time here, but there are so many awesome bootloader videos for you to choose from, including some of those suspend animation ones as well. So you can have a whale of a time looking at what you want to see when you boot up your Steam Deck. This also happens when you transition from the desktop mode to game mode, so you do want to choose something that you like the look of. Then all you need to do is select them for your boot and suspend animations in the Decky menu, and you're good to go. Next up, we have pause games. Now this is an extremely interesting one, as Steam Deck does not like you running more than one game at a time. So if I'm running a game, I can then come into this menu and hit pause game. You can see that I've got the game here and I hit pause and the game immediately freezes. This freezes all resources for the game, unlike you just switching out into the homepage, and you will get a warning when you start up the new game as standard. So if I switch into Stardew Valley here, which isn't a massively intensive game, but what you will notice is that the resources look like it is just running Stardew Valley and doesn't have all the resources tied up with the Callisto protocol in the background. This means that again, you can come into this menu and hit pause on this game, and I now have two games paused and I can use my Steam Deck as I want. This is not only extremely beneficial for games that do not support native pause, but it also means that you can have quick resume style functionality between at least two games. Now I did push the limits to this one. I did try and get it to run with three pause games with The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, but unfortunately The Witcher 3 would not launch with the other two paused. Not sure if this is a bug with the pause games mechanism or just The Witcher 3 not wanting to play ball. So I would recommend only using the pause resume functionality on at least two games, but let me know if you've managed to get it to work on more. Last up in my recommended list is VirantDeck. This one I can't show you with the full screen recording because it only affects the screen. If I change this with it plugged in, it makes no difference, but it gives you saturation menu and also gamma gain menus for individuals so that you can tweak the look of your screen to make it look more vibrant and closer to something like an OLED screen. Now it's never going to achieve quite the same brightness, but if you feel that some of the games look a little bit lackluster on your screen, then you can just change the overall screen saturation to your preferred level. So that's all my recommended plugins at this stage. We keep you up to date with more as they arrive, but let's get into how to install this. Now, the reason I'm redoing this video is one, there is a ton more plugins, but two, Decky Loader has made this 10 times easier to install. So the first thing you need to do is switch over to desktop mode, and then you need to open your browser of choice and just search for Decky Loader. Hit the guys up on their GitHub, which should be the top result here. I'll link it in the description below just in case. And huge shout out to Party Wumpus and all of the other contributors here. This is such an awesome update for Steam Deck, so do make sure that you check out the contributors on here as well. Now all you need to do is scroll down past the top section to this huge download button. Hit the download button. This will download deckyinstaller.desktop. Stick it somewhere easy for you to get to. I just put it on the desktop. But don't run it from the browser, because if you do, it will ask you for a launcher type, and none of these successfully seem to run it. So just come out of the browser and find the location where you downloaded the file. For me, it was desktop, and you'll have this install Decky option. Double click this and accept the prompt, and this will start the process. Now, if you haven't set a sudo password previously, you should just be able to hit OK and install this. However, if you have created a sudo password, then you will need to enter it. Otherwise, you will get an error. If you've set a sudo password and forgotten it, then check out our Oh No, What's My Sudo video in the description below of how to reset it. Once you've put your sudo password in, you have the choice of the release or pre-release branches. Use the release if you're on the normal stable version. If you are on the preview or beta channel for your Steam Deck, then make sure you use the pre-release version here. Once you've picked your version, it will install everything that you need. Once it's finished, it can be closed. Now, if you do want to uninstall this at a later date, you can just come back and rerun the installer. And if the installer does not work and give you the uninstall option for some reason, then you can scroll down on the Decky Loader page to the uninstallation section and copy and paste the console command on this bottom section and just run that in console. Now Decky Loader is installed, you can switch back to game mode. And now if you push the three button menu on the bottom right of your Steam Deck, you will have a new option at the bottom here with the plug icon, which will now give you a Decky menu. Use the settings cog to go into Decky and update plugins in future and update Decky itself if needed. Otherwise, go into the shop or marketplace icon on the right hand side here and you will get the Decky Loader Marketplace. Now you can go through and pick all of the plugins that we covered earlier on in this video and make the most out of your Steam Deck. And I would love to see a update for Decky Loader that manages Proton QT up from game mode, which was available in Crankshaft, but since that's no longer functioning, I would love to see somebody bring that to Decky Loader. If there's another type of plugin that you'd like to see added as well, let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.